Hallmark kids are all geniuses. We know that. But are they physically genetic marvels like, say, LeBron James, who ought to be groomed for sports?
Well, a new test claims that for $170, you can find out. 4-year-old Amanda likes sports already, and tumbling may be in her future. And Kyler appears to be a natural, too. At 3 years old, he's already taking on his big brother, who's twice his age. They love sports. On this night, they turned their living room into an indoor soccer field.
Take a shot.
I'd say it's probably the center focus of our home. My kids are borderline obsessed with sports.
Go get it, Yellow! Challenge her! Yellow, we need you to move up!
Okay.
So when we told Heather Foreman and Amy Schluter about a new test that looks at your child's DNA to see if they have the same genetic makeup as many professional athletes, these moms were ready to try it out.
I may expose him to things that maybe I wouldn't have before.
I think it'll be interesting because I have in my mind an idea of what I think she would be good at, just based on her build and maybe things that I was good at. So it'll be interesting to see if it lines up.
The test is simple.
Open up.
You swab the inside of your child's cheek.
Open up wide and look at mommy.
Then wait 2 to 3 weeks for the results. Atlas Sports Genetics looks at the ACTN3 genes. And if those genes are without something called a variant, Atlas Sports says you're more like an elite athlete, predisposed to sprint and power events. If you have one copy of the variant, the company says you're a mixed performance athlete, good at a wide range of sports like soccer and basketball, but unlike most elite athletes. Same goes if you have two variants. In this case, the company claims you're likely to be good at endurance sports. That's figure skating and long-distance running. After 3 weeks, Kyler and Amanda's moms find out both kids have one copy of the variant, meaning they are unlike most professional athletes, but good at a wide range of sports. Interesting, but not surprising.
The results wouldn't change anything that I would put her in anyway. I'll put her in things that she wants to try. We'll try all kinds of things, and whatever she enjoys doing, we'll let her stick with.
Are you disappointed at all that they didn't come back as elite athletes?
I don't think so, because even if he came back as an elite athlete, I don't think it would have changed anything that we do going forward.
So we took these results to a local geneticist to see what he thinks about this test.
There are so many genes that contribute to strength and to athleticism. To base your future on just one of the 18,000 genes of the body is just ridiculous to me.
Dr. Derek Nielsen with Children's Medical Center says, think of it this way.
Just because you're tall doesn't mean you're going to be a good basketball player. And just because you are not tall doesn't mean you can't compete in the NBA.
So Kyler and Amanda will play for fun. And their parents will continue supporting them no matter what the future holds. Now, one other interesting note, 60% of the time, kids, their tests, they come back as these mixed performance athletes, just like Kyler and Amanda. Only 27% of the time are they these elite athletes, and 13% of the time they're labeled endurance athletes.